take your barcode, and then you just hit scan.
Press that scan button.
And it's cooking for you.
So here's the fun part. I'm not doing anything. And just like that, 20 minutes later, it's done cooking my meal.
How good does this look?
You cannot get this from a microwave.
Tabala, your secret weapon for impossibly convenient home cooking. Get it risk-free for 100 days at Tabala.com.
Have you heard about the morning meeting? It's the Investment Club's daily show, where Jeff, Mark, and I go over all our moves before we make them.
We do a deep dive into the economic analysis that dovetails with actual stocks, so you can best manage your own portfolio. It's live, it's interactive,
and it's unplugged. The morning meeting, another great benefit of the CNBC Investing Club.
Become a CNBC Investing Club member today. Scan this QR code now or go to cnbc.com/join the club. Scan this code or become a member today at cnbc.com/pro.
Welcome back to the second half of Monster Jam at NRG Stadium. Let's head down to the track as we start freestyle. Corey Rubble coming off his first freestyle win of the season at Angel Stadium in Anaheim. Trying to go 2 for 2 here. Here we go, Mr. Extreme Air. Skies it. He's got to clear the berm.
Man, that truck is landing so good. See how it doesn't rebound? The truck actually lands, soaks up the landing, and continues to go forward.
And it's dangerous coming off that pod going into the berm before he got it. That's a brake check. Big time brake check. So he goes from a lot of speed.
That's one of those situations, Scott, where he was heading for one jump, the truck over-rotated, he had to switch it up a little bit. That's why it's so hard as a driver to plan a run, because sometimes something changes like that, and you have to make an adjustment on the fly. Catches a backflip ramp there. Have to be careful. That can easily break an axle.
And a lot of times the truck dictates where you're going, whether you like it or not. So Megalodon now swinging around in front of El Toro Loco. He has got something on his mind right now, coming back over to our side. And here we go.
Backflip City.
First backflip attempt of the night. Lines up Megalodon. Brings it in. Skies it.
Oh, easy peasy, buddy.
Back on all four BKT tires.
And now it's his letter E time.
And there's your whip off the gray side ramp.
Come on, Corey. Go, go, go. Yes, sir. Yep, little whip right there.
And we go red. Well done. Take us through the super glue to the action replay.
Perfect execution of a backflip here. What's awesome, he doesn't even have to catch reverse. He just drops it down in first gear, takes off out of a whole shot. 1-2, shift, and letter E.
9.065 for Corey Rubble. But I still think, Colt, that that's a low score, and it is not an unbeatable score. And we've seen Tyler and Chucky and Barry and Camden and Ryan throw in some runs in the 9.7s, 9.8. So maybe not what Corey Rubble was expecting, but we'll see now how Camden Murphy reacts in Bakugan Dragonoid. He clips the backflip ramp as well. Here we go.
He's just playing around the outside, kind of make a little NASCAR track out of it. You know, he's only got 2 hits so far, but that might be his little game, trying to make sure he makes that 30 seconds, taking it nice and easy. Waiting on Bill, his crew chief, to tell him, go, 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 30 seconds is up.
Yeah, he spent a lot of time driving around the track.
And somebody like Cam, that's a smart move to do that. He needs all the points he can get. Even if he doesn't win, he needs every point possible. And a no score would be detrimental to him right now.
Now listen, he is still in the race for the event championship, coming with 16 points.
That was cool. A little sidewinder out of there. Rear steer turn. 2 wheels. Crossing it up right here. Oh, getting a little wild. Getting a little western. Alright. We're gonna start seeing some big stuff out of camp now.
The back wheels come up, but he's able to settle the truck down. That time he roosts a
backflip ram. Now some more air gets the front two tires down and then back up over the pod. So center lane, rough as they come here in Houston. Less than 30 to go. He is making his way over the backflip ram. He had to drive all the way around the outside to get there, though. 21 seconds. He needs time to let her eat after the flip. Bakugan's riding on big backflip. Oh, man, look at that right up on the front two tires.
Well, looks cool. We almost had it.
It was almost a perfect backflip, but Camden was trying a little bit too hard to get one of those stoppy moonwalks out of the backflip. Puts him right on his lid, cost him the rest of his run. Here comes Caleb Blood in Soldier Fortune.
You know, Cole, you and I have talked so much about the hometown curse. She's out of Lafayette, Louisiana, so not her hometown, but she has a lot of friends and family here. That's something that could be affecting her right now.
Oh, definitely. There's a lot of stress whenever you're close to hometown. You got all your family watching. You want to go out and impress them. You know, we're not really in her hometown. We're only about 3 hours from Lafayette here in Houston, so I'm sure a lot of them made the drive to come watch Caleb burn her down.
Well, Cole, this is your hometown show. You're doing a fine job up here tonight.
Well, thanks, man. She was going to land right on that race lane. Ooh, interesting. Going for that hard corner there. She was committed to that jump.
Here we go. Big jump for Caleb Blood. Little rough on the landing, but she gets over it.
Drives great. Turns into it. Corrects the truck before it actually touches the ground.
Again, right onto the pod.
I thought she was going to come up short, but she nails it.
Man, she keeps the momentum, gets her low center of gravity on the truck, gets all four BKT tires down on the pod.
Truck is getting hot, Scott. I can see some smoke come off the engine already.
Sky Willie landed a little rough, got the nose of the truck down. More smoke from Soldier Fortune.
Kayla's definitely just hitting whatever's in front of her right now.
Cross-threading, and she lands real rough.
She's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Well, she's able to save it.
That was an aggressive side slap.
Take us to the Super Glue Glue to the action replay.
Kayla comes out. She makes lots of noise, hits everything in front of her. Truck's crooked. She drives out of it. Unfortunately, she runs out of time before she can get to the backflip ramp.
All right, next up, here comes Tyler Menega in Gravedigger. And called two freestyle wins on the year already for Tyler. And he won freestyle in this building in October. He has tied right now with Charlie Pawkin at the top of the leaderboard. He's got to have a lot of confidence coming in to this run.
Oh, definitely a lot of confidence. But I got to tell you what, he's got to be careful. Too much confidence on a tacky track like this can bite you real quick.
Setting up, going to test the shocks right out of the gate. A 1-2, go! And gets a great jump. Nearly clears that chalk line.
Easy, buddy. Oh, one to hike up on him. He's riding the edge right there coming around. All right, let's see if he downsides right here. Yeah, brake check perfect. Right in. Oh, yeah.
Gets the back of the truck.
Stop it.
Saves it. Yep, there you
go. Throwing some skills in. He's going to go reverse. Yep, there it is. Throwing some more skills. Great execution right there. That's so hard to do, Scott. Slow down your thinking, get out of that freestyle mode, go back to skills real quick, and then now get right back into that freestyle wide open mode.
I mean, the margin of error there, Cole, is incredibly slim. He was right on the edge of that pod and stopped it on a dime right there.
Great truck awareness.
Oh, yeah.
Right to the center.
And then gets
perfect bounce. Look at the brake checks. You got to have those brake checks. Oh, man, we might have a broke sway bar. See how slinky it was right there?
I do. The four-time Triple Threat Series champion silenced his critics this year on the Stadium Championship Series.
Something's broke. Something's broke. Definitely a sway bar. Something is not holding the truck up. That's what a sway bar does.
Oh, shifts it back to the left.
It actually keeps the truck from doing exactly what it's doing. Actually, might even be a shock. He's got some major issues. Oh, yeah, front sway bar is broke. On that truck, unfortunately, it's going to cost him. Did he get 30 seconds, Scott?
He did get 30 seconds, but if he scores low, Charlie Pawkin and Ryan Anderson move up to the front of the dinner table for the event championships. We take a look at the Super Glue glued to the action replay.
See, Tyler Meninga's out here absolutely going huge from the start. I love that brake check.
driving the truck into exactly where he wants. So right here, pops up on the front two, goes into a stop, he backs up, throws some skills moves in on there. Let's see if we can see exactly where he breaks that front sway bar. I think it's right here. See the truck land. Yep, Swaybar just couldn't handle it. Unfortunately, it cost Tyler early. And the reason being is if that Swaybar is hanging down, tech officials cannot allow him to run. It's a safety hazard if the Swaybar hits a tire or something and goes flying off.
The carnage filled freestyle here in Houston. Not everybody could get into the action. So let's take a look at our bottom five freestyle scores. Mike Christensen in the back in the pits working on Vendetta. He would not make it out to the track. His brother Paul Jensen in Jurassic Attack didn't fill the first 30 seconds of the clock, so he did not get a score as well. Jim Kohler in Avenger had a motor issue. He finished in 10th. Preston Perez in the Ron Ryan Show filmed the clock, did not get a great score. And then Craig Champion, El Toro Loco, had some big moments and filled the clock, but he would finish with a bottom five score. Let's take a look now at our current freestyle top five. Corey Rummel, Meg Lenau with the top spot. Camden Murphy in second. Tyler Menega third. Caleb Blood in fourth. And Craig Champion rounding out our current freestyle top five. Just three more trucks remain, but some of the highest flyers in the sport. It's Anderson Pocket and Moosehauer, and they hit the track next.